brother. I feel go baba dey say yo. Hey Jesus.
I don't know what you're saying. I'm not sure. We thank you at a time such as this. Annette was born in the home, and now her maker has requested her to come home. So now we release him. We release her as a family. We release her. We welcomed her when she was born. And then she came to the earth and did everything that the Lord instructed her. Now the Lord is called her home. Therefore, the family will release her unto her God, unto her maker. So we ask that F, receive her in glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. quite far. Is it coming?
When they come out, we'll work continue.
Yeah.
Please stand, everyone. We receive the body of our sister Annette Owusu-Ansah with confidence in God, the giver of life, who raised the Lord Jesus from the dead.
Thank you.
We meet in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Please be seated for a minute. I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. Welcome to everyone here this morning. We are gathered here today to give thanks for the life and to honor the memory of our sister, Annette, Owusu-Ansah, a wife, mother, grandmother, a sister, an aunt, and a friend. Annette lived her life with much love and laughter, creativity, and all who knew or met her will remember her with warmth, and as a woman with great devotion and dedication to her family. Annette's family also remembers her as being a devout Christian, and was committed to St. Paul's Church, right where you are this morning, for many years up until the pandemic caused our doors to be closed. Today we have all come here to share the memories we hold of her, to share in your common grief, and to share and to show our common respect. This morning we will feel some sorrow, but perhaps it will also be an opportunity for us to give thanks that Annette has lived among us, and she has left much legacy behind for her family and those who knew her. And so we are thankful to God Almighty for the gift of life, and we are thankful to God that Annette lived here on this earth. And now we prepare to say farewell. Farewell to her, to commit her into the hands of our loving Heavenly Father. But of course, those who mourn need our prayers and our support and our love, and we continue to remember in our prayers and thoughts Annette's children, her grandchildren, her husband, and indeed her friends and other family. So let us pray. God our Father, by raising Christ your Son, you destroy the power of death and open for us the way to eternal life. As we remember before you our sister, Annette Owusu-Ansah, we ask for help, for your help, for all who gather in her memory. Grant us the assurance of your presence and grace by the Spirit you have given us through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, we don't know what this means, but we are going to stand and sing. I know that we've been told to now wear masks again in buildings, but we have not been told yet that we cannot sing. So we will stand and we will sing our first hymn, How Great Thou Art. Please stand.
Thank you. Margaret Amoa is stuck somewhere in traffic, so she delegated me to read on her behalf. The first reading is taken from the book of John, chapter 14, verses 1 to 3. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, I would have told you that I am going to told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come and take you to me with me, that you also may be there. This is the word of God. The second reading is from the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, verses 1 to 8. A time for everything. There is a time for everything, and a season for every activity under the heavens. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to uproot. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stories and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to search and a time to give up. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to mend. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you very much for those two very important readings, two of the readings that we will often hear at services like this. But before we carry on to our sermon, just a few words on that reading from John's Gospel. I'm going to invite some people up to pay tribute to Annette. So we have Kwame, Well, Kwame, Jackie, Kojo, Beverly, and then of course we have Kojo, Harrietta, and a tribute which will be introduced, a video tribute which will be introduced by Annette's grandchildren. So please do come forward if you are reading a tribute. Please do come forward.
First and foremost, I'd like to thank every single one of you for attending Mum's funeral. This is the hardest. This is the hardest thing I've ever had. I've had to do in my life. I just want to thank every single one of you for attending. Our dear mother was full of life and grace. She had so much courage and strength, which we can honestly say was passed down to us. Mum was a serial entrepreneur, fashion guru, a multiple business owner, property developer, and more importantly, a loving wife and mother. She was an enterprising person, believing, striving for success, and had a resilient attitude towards accomplishing achievements.
Hi everyone, I just want to say thank you for supporting us. This has been very difficult, but we couldn't thank you enough for all the endless support, all the love. We really appreciate you. Mum always advised us not to take no as a negative answer, but we should use this term for motivation, which is why she always succeeded. Mum made sure those core values were instilled in each and every one of us. Being a super proud parent, she's taught us to believe in ourselves, chase the dream, and success will follow. She always said, don't leave what you can do today for tomorrow, as tomorrow is never promised. And that life is for living and enjoying with family and friends. We can truly say that our mother enjoyed herself, even on her last days on this earth. Thank you, guys. Thank you all for being here today. Mum will be happy that so many of you are here today in celebration of her life here today. And I'd like to say that today we celebrate her life. We're not going to just mourn her, we're going to celebrate her. I'm going to do a reading from Psalm 23, verse 1 to 6. A Psalm of David. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul, and he leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows with blessing. Mum always told me, we'll have conversations, and she would say to me, Jackie, if you don't read at my funeral, I'll be upset. And I'm like, Mum, why are you talking like this? And she's like, no, because we'll watch things together. And she goes, I just want you to make sure that you read at my funeral. And I said, Mum, I'll read at your funeral. That's why I'm standing here today. And Mum, I'm honoring you, and I'm reading for you. Although you are gone, and it is so unexpected, we want to say thank you, Mum. Thank you for being the best mother that you could ever be to any of us. You raised us well, and you raised us to be strong, and you raised us to be resilient, strong. Young gentlemen and young ladies, you even had the strength to be able to raise my children too, as your own, and you did it with dear grace. Thank you for raising 4 wonderful children.
Supporting all our dreams and encouraging all of us to keep going. Mum was the pillar. She was the foundation to our family. Our family home feels empty without you, Mum. We all miss you very much. We would give anything to hold you one last time. And seeing her beautiful dimples, Mum, it's so hard to say goodbye. But we know that you're resting at peace. And you with God in heaven. One thing about me is that I was in the States and I felt like giving up. But because of Mum, I kept on going. I kept on going. She said, I'm so proud of you. You know, you're doing what you love. You know, your fashion career, keep going. I even wrote a testimony at church and I said, if it wasn't for Mum, I would not be there. She has been my backbone. She has supported me through every single thing that I've been doing. Everything that I've done in the States is for her. And I will continue to make her proud. We're all gonna make her proud. Mm-hmm. And we promise to take care of Daddy too. Mm-hmm. Daddy, we're gonna take care of you. You promise? Mm-hmm. You promise? We're gonna take care of you. I'm so sorry. Mm-hmm. Sorry.
This is not a goodbye, Mom. This is just, it's simply, we'll meet again. One day, we'll rejoice and we'll love again. We shall look after one another. We love you. Rest well, our day angel. We know you are there. Mum, we miss you wholeheartedly and you are forever in our hearts.
I love you, Mum. Rest in peace. To our dearest beloved departed, the white mist of dew in the gentle morning's glow, ready to nurture the young tender flowers and grazing those. In her outstretched humility towards humanity, altruistic, impartial, a caring attitude, gentle breeze, smile. In her passionate, compassionate, rich to others, genuine, sincerity, a wholehearted embrace. Her arms never shortened to reach the furthest of distance, from Monaco to Timbuktu. Held the family in a pivoted anchor discipline. Good training, respect for others, and for the children to take full responsibility, self-esteem, control, and charge. In this age abroad, when parents overpumped their young, she never spared the rod, but chastised them, always, never neglecting her young one who had needs. She became a friend, a sister, a mother, a father, and all for him not to miss out any part of his life. Her scrumptious, yummy, luscious, delectable, mouth-watering cuisines, the cause for heavenly angels' descent. A clouded kitchen, indeed. Yet, surprisingly, enough to feed a whole army, so don't be in a hurry. Her beauteous, dark skin gracefully allowed the sun to enlighten her path. The moon shined upon her embrace, a lit in her path illuminate. That exquisite, flair, flamboyant, exuberant wave of personality, the mild and metal charisma emboldened,
the blues of musical concerto in that magical enchantment, a fairy tale godmother she was. Not procrastinating, took charge, and no waiting, so don't be long. Who could have lived such a splendid life in style, in colors, and the abrupt end, painless of anyone's time consuming and effortless waste. Her final message and goodbye in her designer most gorgeous outfit, posted on social media to keep her memories fresh in that red wine, colorful, vivid reality. The mark of remembrance stands a reflection of her life towards her last dance. In that red sat her in charisma, a white chariot drawn carriage. To remember that she lived her dreams fully a reality. Goodbye. 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 You taught us all. You taught the world.
Tribute by the Helen. We're going to start by reading from John chapter 16, verse 22. So with you, now is your time of grief, but I will see you again, and you will rejoice, and no one will take away your joy. My dear Effia Annette, you have left a huge hole in my heart nobody can begin to fulfill. As I sit here currently thinking over in my head, how have you left me? If I had known it was going to be our last time, I would have embraced you even more. I would have made your last hour, minute, second full of happiness. We have been together for over 40 years. We started our lives together and built a legacy which will carry on through our children's children. When I first saw you, you were the most beautiful girl I had ever had my eyes on. I said to myself, hey, this girl is fine. You were standing there waiting for a bath and you caught my eye. I tried to panel the courage to talk to you as I wasn't looking my best. You were dressed in the finest clothes and I could tell you were a high maintenance girl. However, that did not stop me. Although it took a year before you even acknowledged me, but you were definitely worth the chase. We had our traditional marriage in Ghana before settling to the UK in January 1982. God has blessed us dearly with four incredible children, two boys, two girls, and five beautiful grandchildren. My life partner is now gone. Annette, I miss you so much. When I wake up in the morning, you are no more there. Who do I tell my worries to? Who do I plan with? You were always guiding me with your advice and our life plans. I love the way you were very passionate when you believed in something. Very kind-hearted and giving. Your love is endless. When you love someone, you make sure you go through extreme length to help, no matter who the person is. When your mind was made up, nobody could convince you because you were a woman of substance and class, whom others used to seek advice from, not limited to being attentive, warm-hearted, compassionate, classy, hardworking, supportive, encouraging, and loving. God truly blessed me with the best wife, mother and grandmother anyone can truly ask for. Nobody can fulfill your role. I'm so very grateful that you chose me to be your husband, your life partner. Only God knows why he called you too soon, as I can never reach the answers I seek. And as we say, only God knows. With the Lord in a better place. One day we shall be together again. We always think of you daily as you are here with us in spirit. We shall never stop loving you. Your legacy will live on through our children. Rest peacefully, my sweet love, until we meet again. Amen.
I'm reading this on behalf of my mum, Harriet. Through all the changing scenes of life, in trouble and in joy, the praises of my God shall still my heart and tongue employ. I still can't process that I'm writing this. Since the day you left us, I have been broken that my dear friend, my sister of almost 40 years, is no longer with us. There is not a day that goes by when I don't think of everything he meant to me. I catch myself smiling at the fond memories we had together, watching our children go together, our sleepovers, our day-long trips to the shops, especially Harrods. And then I remember that you're no longer here, and the pain and the sadness hits me all over again. Annette, you were more than family to me. You are the most selfless and beautiful human inside and out that I've ever known. Your heart was so pure and so full of so much warmth, and I'm devastated that I will no longer experience your love. Through the ups and downs of life, you've always been there for me and so many others. I can never thank you enough for the support, kindness and wisdom you have shared with me. Thank you for always being there for me, for giving me strength in dark times and for all the laughter and joy we have shared. I miss you beyond belief, but I hold firm in the faith that we will meet again one day. Thank you.
Thank you for all being here today. I am now going to introduce Kojo's song for Mom and a tribute video I have put together for the family.
Mommy, just want to thank you. Thank you for everything you've done for me. Words cannot express how hurt and heartbroken I am. I feel so empty without you. You've always taught me to be the best version of myself. I appreciate you, I love you, and I will always love you. It's hard, it's very, very hard. I find that it's so difficult. But I'm just taking everything day by day. I will continue celebrating you. Every day, every minute, every hour. I will look after the family just like you did. May your soul rest in perfect peace. I love you, Mom.
Mom, you are the pillar of our family. You'll never be forgotten and you're always in our hearts. We love you forever. Rest in peace, our angel.
Mom, I love you, Mom. Rest in peace. And God help you. Amen. Rest in peace, Mom. Love you, Mom.
My beautiful queen, my backbone, my inspiration, my biggest cheerleader and supporter, my whole heart. Words cannot describe how I miss you every second, Mom. Everything that I was building in the United States was because of your encouragement and motivation to keep going. I feel so blessed, honored, and glad to have featured in the Gucci campaign with you, Mom. They kept mentioning how beautiful you are and your smile. And I said to them, well, I do get it from my mama. When I gave my testimony at church, I mentioned that you were the reason why I never gave up. You told me not to come back until I've given my all. Mom, you have helped me achieve so much in this life. You are a superwoman and God has truly gifted you. I promise to keep going and will make you proud forever until we meet again. Your care, Chile, baby last. I love you, Mommy. May your soul rest in perfect peace. You'll always be,
you will always be. Dear Grandma, you are such an exceptional woman. You taught me so much and I'm grateful for the 18 years I've had with you. Thank you for always being there for me, for teaching me and encouraging me and guiding me. I love you so much, Grandma. Rest in perfect peace. I'll miss you always.
Hey, Grandma, it's me, Susanette. Adoring face, as you used to call me. I miss you so much, and yeah, you've now gained your wings. I hope you enjoy yourself in heaven. If only heaven had open hours, I miss you so much.
Dear Grandma, hopefully you care. I really miss you.
Thank you so much for that. Ah, that was refreshing and beautiful and very inspiring. I think we would all agree that Annette has lived a very full life. She never holds back. But we're going to have one more final piece of information or story of Annette's life and what she gave to her community and her family, her children. So her eulogy will be, is it Kojo?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, you're doing this. Can we come forward?
I believe everybody is just as emotional as I am with the goose pimple. The final eulogy, not very long, 3 pages only. Only joking, because it's halfway each page. Today we are honoring, celebrating, and remembering the most precious woman. Our beloved mother, wife, grandma, sister, and dear friend, Annette Owusu-Ansah. The family of Annette would like to take this opportunity to thank everyone for being here today and for your comforting words and prayers during this unimaginable difficult times. Annette was born to Mr. Kofi Owusu and Madam Ya Jama in Kumasi, Ghana. She came from a big family and shared a close bond with her parents, siblings, and extended family. As she would always say, there was always someone to celebrate your joys with. Annette was talented and savvy from an early age and excelled at dressmaking in her teens. By the age of 17, she had started her own fashion business, designing, making, and selling costume-made clothes. The business would eventually take her abroad, traveling across Europe before eventually settling into the UK. Growing up in a close-knit family, Annette had always placed a high priority on family, marriage, and motherhood. At the age of 22, and while running a fashion business in Ghana, Annette met a then young man at 23 years old, Mr. Owusu Bempa, whom we all know as Awule, whom she would later marry for the rest of the day. It was love at first sight for Awule. He spotted Annette at a bus stop in Kumasi, Ghana, and was instantly mesmerized by such a beautiful, enchanting style. Their love story would, however, unfold a year later, since the chance encountered at the bus stop. Mr. Owusu courted Annette for just over a year before she gave him a chance. As God's plans would have it, Mr. Owusu was a friend of Annette's cousin who happened to live in Annette's family home. He became a regular, or should we say, a permanent fixture in Annette's family home. And over time, she grew fond of him. And as the saying goes, the rest is history. As indeed, they got married in London and had 4 most beautiful children. 2 boys, Kwabe and Kujo, and 2 girls, Jacqueline and Beverly. The family made a home in Tottenham, North London, later moving to a beautiful home in Enfield. Annette was a devoted Christian, and her regular place of worship was right here in this church, St. Paul's and Old House. She trained in health and social care and went on to be a senior for Enfield Home Care Services before recently retiring, not excluding her love of property building and other business excursions such as opening boutiques and other stores. Annette was full of life and grace. She had so much courage and strength, which she had passed down to her children and 4 grandchildren, Chelsea, Susanette, Angelina, and Victoria. Annette took so much pride and joy in her children and grandchildren. They, in return, became completely deserted with her. That shared love and adoration between mother and child, grandma and grandchild will never fade away. Annette was the definition of a go-getter and believed in striving for higher and better achievements in life, no matter who you are. And this is what she instilled in her family. She would always say, you have to believe in yourself. You must have courage and force yourself in this world. If you do not, you cannot be successful. There was nothing more important to Annette than family and her Christian faith. If she considered you a friend, you were also considered family. Her hospitality was second to none. Any guest of Annette would always leave her home with a smile and a full belly. She was the consummate host and was always warm and welcoming to everyone. We would always remember Annette's kind heart, passionate soul, and vibrant personality. Her eloquent style, matching outfits and handbags were her trademark. Her advice and guidance, her reassurances, her cuddles, her glowing smile, her infectious laughter, and her most powerful voice, which filled the whole room with grace. Our beloved mother, wife, grandma, sister, and dear friend, Annette Owusu-Ansah, we love you and miss you beyond measure. We will continue to lead our lives in the way you taught us to believe in ourselves, to work hard, and to have courage and faith. It will never be goodbye. You will stay in our hearts, thoughts, conversations, and prayers forever. Rest well in God's loving arms. The year. Matthew 11:28-30. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Psalm 62:5-8. Yes, my soul, find rest in God. My hope comes from him. Truly he is my rock and my salvation. He is my fortress. I will not be shaken. My salvation and my honor depend on God. He is my mighty rock, my refuge. Trust in him all times. You people, pour out your hearts to him, for God is our refuge. Thank you very much.
Let us just listen now to a few words from, based on this reading that we heard earlier from John's Gospel, chapter 14. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God. Believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. In this reading that we've just heard, we catch a glimpse of what the disciples were experiencing as they began to realize that Jesus would not be with them much longer. And having a sense of what the disciples might have been experiencing, it's quite daunting because we too experience the same feeling. No one can take away from what you are feeling today, your grief. Many people struggle with grief because there is a sense we must grieve now, not later. because grieving now will seem more genuine. But grief does not work in this way. Grief grips us when we least expect it, when the reality hits us that something has changed in our world. And guess what? That is when the grief is genuine. But there are others who must grieve now, because for them grief is more immediate. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? Let us look at what Jesus Christ has promised his disciples, and indeed what he has promised us here today. The first is that peace is promised to us. Note the words, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. Peace. Yes, I know that today is a day of sadness for many of us, or all of us, a day of grief, a day of mourning, yet even in the midst of this, you can have peace. Why? Because we have faith and we believe. We believe that even in the midst of our storms or grief or losing someone we love, even in the valley of the shadows of death, there can be peace that passes all understanding, because we know that God is with us. The disciples felt all those things as well. Their week had begun gloriously with Jesus' triumphant entry into Jerusalem, with people waving palms and branches, and now they have begun to realize that Jesus won't be with them much longer. The disciples were understandably upset, and so Jesus looked at them with tenderness and said, let not your hearts be troubled. The tense here means to stop letting your hearts be afraid, be troubled, indicating that they were falling apart. What do we do now? Because the one on whom we rely is no longer going to be with us. What are we going to do? What are we going to do? The word your is plural when Jesus says, let not your. As Jesus moves from talking to Peter, if we go back, Jesus is speaking to Peter on his own, and then he now turns to all of the disciples. Troubled mean to be stirred up. Let not your heart be stirred up. Anxious. Put all anxiety aside. But then Jesus offers comfort. Comfort in the thought that God has prepared a place for all of us, if we want it, because we have to want it as well. Did you notice that in John 14 it says, I go to prepare a place for you, Jesus says. The Bible tells us that in the 6 days God created the heavens and the earth. But just think, Jesus has been preparing a place for us for 2,000 years. 2,000 years. What a place that must be. The verse tells us that it is the Father's house and that there are many rooms. A room for Annette, a room for you, a room for me, a room for all of us. Isn't that comforting to know that we all have a room with God? God has prepared a place for us. Do you want that place? I do. But look, we are not left to find our own way to that place, are we? Because Jesus made a promise that he will come back and take us to be with him, so that where he is, there you will be also. What a promise and what comfort. I bet when the disciples heard that their heart heard this, their heart lit up. They cheered up. Oh, he's coming back for us. He's coming back for us. They must have felt a sense of relief that one day they will be reunited with their Lord. Think of how you feel or felt when a loved one leaves for overseas. Many of us are too familiar with that. Those of us who have relatives who want to travel overseas for a better life have experienced that at some point in our life. And you feel a sense of loss, and you hug them and say, I will miss you, and then they whisper in your ear, don't worry, I will come back. I will be back. They don't always come back very quickly, do they? It always takes a bit of time. Sometimes they come back quickly, but sometimes it takes a bit of time. And that day when they return, you are so elated, excited, and you are filled with joy because one whom you love has finally returned. We are in the season of Advent, a time of waiting and preparing. Advent, a time of waiting and preparing. When our loved ones leave, go overseas, we wait for them to return. But we don't just wait, we prepare for them to return. And that's what happens with us and our promise in Jesus Christ. My friends, this peace, this place, and this promise has also been extended to Annette. And now her Lord and Savior, and our Lord and Savior, will come again and will take her by the hand, and he will lead her to that place, so that where he is, there she will be also. And that place is promised to us as well. But my question to all of us here this morning is, how are we preparing for that day? I know many of us are preparing for Christmas. I had two assemblies this week in school, and we talked about what Advent means in Christmas, and we say Christmas isn't about eating and drinking, we think it is. Having a service of this nature isn't about a party, eating or drinking. Having a wedding isn't about eating or drinking. A baptism isn't about eating or drinking. It is much more than that. It is about what it is that we're preparing for. The coming of Christ at Christmas. So let us also prepare for that place the same way we prepare for Christmas. Let us prepare our hearts and our minds for that day when we shall all be reunited with the Lord when our time comes. Amen. Can we stop the video now so that I think we're going to pray? Just for a minute. You know, when you look back, sometimes there might be things we regret, but God holds all things together and calls us to come to him. All those who are feeling burdened and heavy laden, and he will give you rest. So confident in the love and forgiveness of God, let us reflect on those things we may have said that we wish we hadn't said, those things we had put off saying, and those things we regret saying. So let us now keep silent as we reflect on our own heart, asking God for his forgiveness. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought and word and deed, and in what we have left undone. We are heartily sorry, and we repent of all our sins. For your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. A prayer for the life of our sister Annette. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us all with the gift of this earthly life, and has given to Annette her span of years and gift of character. God our Father, we thank you now for her life, for every memory of love and joy, for every good deed done by her and every sorrow shared with us. We thank you for the rest in Christ she now enjoys. We thank you for giving her to us. We thank you for the glory we shall share together. Hear our prayers through Jesus Christ, our Lord. And for those who mourn, we pray your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Look in mercy on all who mourn. We ask particularly for Kwame, Jackie, Kojo, Beverly, Harriet, Annette's grandchildren. In their sadness and grief, strengthen them with the knowledge of your love. Give them grace and strength for tomorrow and the days to come. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us now say the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. My friends, please stand as we sing our final hymn, It Is Well With My Soul. Is that one? No?
Amazing Grace.
Amazing Grace, rather, sorry. We're going to sing Amazing Grace together.
Thank you.
Please remain standing as we commend our sister Annette to God's mercy. Before we do that, the family of Annette would like to say thanks to everyone who have been praying for them, praying with them, supporting them with your cards and words of encouragement, and of course, your love for them during this difficult time. So thank you all so very much. I believe that the family has organized a celebration of life, which will happen elsewhere. Do people know where that is? Lee Valley, is it here?
Yes.
Where? What page?
It's Lee Valley.
So we will continue to celebrate the life of Annette in Lee Valley.
Park Royal.
Do we all know where that is?
Oh, yes.
Okay, you'll find it. Okay. Please remain standing.
Yes.
Will you get me?
Yes,
okay.
Please.
All right. Yeah. My mouth is very loud, so please listen. Gracious God, nothing in death or life, nothing in the world as it is, nothing in the world as it shall be, nothing in all creation can separate us from your love. Jesus commended his spirit into your hands at his last hour. Into those same hands we commend your servant Annette, that dying to the world and cleansed from sin, death may be for her the gate to life and to eternal fellowship with you through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
For our final blessing. Jesus offers us life in the water of baptism. Even life after death. May God grant you a share in the inheritance of his saints in glory, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you. Oh, before we have our final blessing, we're in Advent. Next week is next week Sunday, not this Sunday coming. The following, next week Sunday, we have the family will be returning to St. Paul's, and so you are invited to come to that Mass when there will be a celebration in the hall here after Mass on next Sunday. Not this Sunday coming, but the third Sunday of Advent. Okay? And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Go in peace to love the Lord and love each other. Amen.
give myself away so you can use me. Here I am, and here I stand. Lord, my life is in your hands.
Thank you.
So sad. loves you to sleep. I know that I'll be looking know that the peace that you dream of is the same everlasting love. You know I watched you carry all this weight upon your shoulders.
Everlasting love.
Francis, your contest, you are. Well, my turn in for a change. Near 40 and you will be here. Oh, don't go and wait, you are. Sorry, but you are not coming to me. See me, you will meet you, will meet away. Well, my uncle goes in your heart. Now you're your vocal.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.